NASA recently announced a major discovery. They found water on the sunlit side of the moon.
In the vast cosmos, the moon has forever been a guiding light in our nightly skies. But what if our knowledge of this celestial neighbor is just the beginning? Do we truly grasp the mysteries that lie beyond our home planet? And as recent discoveries are reshaping long-held beliefs, with visionaries like Elon Musk leading the charge in a lunar revolution, Musk seems to hint at hidden lunar surprises. Could he hold a cosmic secret? Is there an untold story waiting to be unveiled? Is there more to the moon than we realize? Let's investigate, because Elon Musk's track record of breaking the mold and reshaping entire industries reaches far beyond our planet's borders. Through his company's relentless exploration efforts and Elon Musk's own musings, it becomes clear that the moon is more than just a cosmic neighbor. It's a crucial piece of the grand cosmic puzzle, but is there a secret project Musk is brewing under the surface? There's reason to wonder. Musk's insatiable curiosity aligns with recent discoveries, such as India's Space Research Organization detecting signs of water on the moon and NASA's high-flying aircraft. Sophia finding water in a sunlit region without even touching the lunar surface. So now you know that his knowledge is based on scientists' research and finding, and that's why he has shaken hands with Chinese scientists as well. You can check it in his Twitter feeds as well. Scientists have dug deep into the moon's past, unlocking its secrets about how it came to be, its dramatic history, and its fascinating connection with our own planet. These groundbreaking discoveries haven't gone unnoticed. The highly respected International Mineralogical Association, a worldwide authority on minerals, has regularly given its seal of approval to the findings from lunar missions. This isn't just a pat on the back. It's proof that top-notch research has completely transformed our knowledge of minerals, rocks, and space science. Among the astonishing revelations during these lunar journeys, one in particular has everyone excited. This is a moment worth celebrating, especially for space enthusiast Elon Musk, who's known for advocating for clean and sustainable energy. While minerals and water on the moon are undoubtedly valuable, there's an element that's even more intriguing than helium-3. Enter helium-3, a type of helium that's abundant on the moon's surface but quite rare on Earth. What makes helium-3 so exciting? It has the potential to be a game changer in the world of energy. Elon Musk, the mastermind behind Tesla and SolarCity, isn't just curious about helium-3. He sees it as a possible solution to our energy challenges. But why all the hype? Well, it all comes down to how helium-3 can be used in something called nuclear fusion. Now forget about the nuclear power you might know, where atoms are split and we get energy along with dangerous radioactive waste. Nuclear fusion is a different beast. It's about combining atoms. When helium-3 gets involved in fusion reactions, it promises a super efficient, incredibly powerful, and remarkably clean energy source. The best part? The waste produced from helium-3 fusion is next to nothing, and it's not radioactive. Elon Musk, always looking ahead, sees helium-3's enormous potential. SpaceX and other ventures have been quietly planning lunar missions, but it's not just about exploring or colonizing the moon. It's about tapping into the moon's potential to improve life on Earth and beyond. And helium-3, with its immense energy potential, could be the key to this future. In the 21st century, lunar exploration has seen a resurgence. It's evolved from the Cold War space race into a cooperative yet fiercely competitive mission involving nations and private companies worldwide. The moon, with its untapped resources and untold potential, has ignited a fresh passion among these explorers. Just when you thought you couldn't be more surprised, Elon Musk, the man known for his audacious goals, throws another curveball. Through SpaceX, he has made his grand vision clear, establishing a permanent human presence on the moon. For Musk, the moon isn't just a stepping stone to Mars, it's a destination in itself. It's a place where vital resources, especially water, can be extracted to support both moon inhabitants and deeper space exploration. The idea of living on the moon, once deemed impossible by many, is a dream Musk is determined to turn into reality. And this dream recently got a significant boost from an unexpected source. Chinese lunar landers discovered water on the moon's surface. But this isn't just a mere trace of water. These are substantial volumes that could revolutionize how we plan and execute lunar missions. This discovery has two big implications. First, from a scientific point of view, it makes us wonder about the moon's past. Did it have a more exciting history than we thought? Second, from a practical standpoint, moon water could be turned into rocket fuel and breathable air for astronauts. That's pretty cool, right? Now here's the twist. For a long time, we all believed the moon was totally dry. The early Apollo missions and our earlier studies supported this idea. But as our technology got better, we started to question that belief. Recent findings made us rethink everything. Turns out the moon might not be as dry as we thought. A new era of lunar exploration, with global players competing to unlock the moon's mysteries, and dreamers like Elon Musk envisioning bustling lunar cities. It's like the moon, our quiet neighbor, is stepping into the spotlight. Now let's talk about what happens when we discover something new. It's like opening a door to a room filled with questions. When scientists found signs of hydration on the moon, it was no different. They dived deep into lunar samples trying to figure out what this hydration really was. But was it good old water, like we have in our oceans, or was it something called hydroxyl? Now I know it might sound like a small detail, but in the science world, it's a big deal. Hydroxyl is a bit like water's quirky cousin. It's made up of similar elements, oxygen and hydrogen, but the way they're put together is different. And here's the kicker, that small difference can make a huge change in how these compounds behave. To put it in simple terms, water is stable and friendly, while hydroxyl can be a bit of a troublemaker. Like the substances you find in drain cleaners, don't get us wrong, lunar hydration isn't the same as household cleaning products, but drawing this comparison helps emphasize how reactive hydroxyl can be compared to good old, reliable water. It's all about understanding the moon's secrets and the science that goes into it. Now here's where it gets really interesting. When scientists realized that the moon might have hydroxyl instead of water, it raised a big question. What would this mean for the moon's history and how it formed? To find out, researchers went back to the samples collected during the Apollo missions. These missions, which took place between 1969 and 1972, brought back a whopping 382 kilograms of lunar material. Back then, the main focus was on understanding how the moon came into being and its overall geology. These Apollo samples were like a time capsule from the early days of space exploration. During Apollo 11, Aldrin held a crucial role as the lunar module pilot, responsible for managing the complex lunar module known as the Eagle. His job was no small feat. He had to ensure the Eagle could safely land on the moon, take off, and rendezvous with the command module. Every switch, every light, and every piece of data was under his watchful eye. The heart-pounding moment came during the descent to the moon. As the Eagle separated from the command module, it was Aldrin who guided it to the lunar surface. They faced numerous challenges: navigation issues, computer alarms, boulders on the landing site, and dangerously low fuel. But Aldrin, along with Armstrong, handled it all with incredible composure, making split-second decisions that secured their safe landing on the moon's surface in the Sea of Tranquility. He firmly believes that we're not alone in this vast expanse. When you consider the mind-boggling vastness of the cosmos, with billions of galaxies, each filled with billions of stars and countless planets orbiting those stars, it seems almost unbelievable that Earth is the sole harbor for life. Aldrin's point is simple yet profound. In the face of such immense grandeur, the notion that Earth is a unique cosmic rarity becomes incredibly small. If we as humans can venture to our own moon, why couldn't other life forms be out there gazing at their own moons and stars, pondering the limitless possibilities just like us? Buzz Aldrin's passion for space exploration and his dedication to unraveling the mysteries of the cosmos are crystal clear. He's ventured into the unknown, and from his firsthand experience, he carries a conviction that resonates through the very fabric of space-time. We are not alone. And speaking of discoveries, today's advanced analytical techniques have revealed something that initially defied belief: traces of hydration that had remained hidden until now. The investigation was incredibly thorough. When ancient lunar samples were compared with recent ones, it promised to give us valuable insights into how water and hydroxyl compounds have shaped the moon's history. This research wasn't just about putting together the moon's hydration story. It was about creating a bridge between the past and the present. The Apollo missions, once celebrated as monumental human achievements, were now playing a crucial role in cutting-edge scientific exploration. The moon, with its tranquil and icy exterior, has silently observed Earth's ever-changing history. Its surface, covered in countless craters, holds secrets of celestial collisions and cosmic events. Some areas on the moon are perpetually shrouded in darkness, never touched by the sun's rays, and it was in these eternal shadows that scientists made an astonishing discovery: ice. Yes, ice on the moon. It shattered the long-held belief that the moon was a desolate desert. Where there's ice, there's the potential for water, and this revelation sent shockwaves of excitement through the scientific community. Could it be that the moon, often seen as a barren world, holds secrets beneath its surface? Discoveries from Apollo mission samples have turned our understanding upside down. Initially thought to confirm a dry lunar landscape, these samples have surprised us with the presence of water molecules. This isn't just a small revelation. It's a complete rewrite of lunar history that challenges what we thought we knew about our closest celestial neighbor. In response to this exciting revelation, NASA decided to dig even deeper, using the Stratospheric Observatory for Infrared Astronomy, known as SOFIA. This unique aircraft made it possible to precisely measure water, even on sunlight parts of the moon, a feat once considered impossible due to the sun's intense heat. The findings from SOFIA exceeded all expectations. Water wasn't confined to dark craters, it was scattered across sunlight regions too. This discovery isn't just a scientific breakthrough, it's an invitation to envision the moon as a potential hub for space exploration and, possibly, colonization. With water so widespread, the moon could become a vital resource for future deep space missions. In the midst of this global excitement, China's Chang'e 5 mission took the spotlight, with its objective to collect lunar samples, promising to unravel more of the moon's mysteries. Photographs from lunar missions ignited wild speculations. Was it evidence of alien civilizations, or perhaps remnants from an undiscovered mission? As curiosity grew, scientists and space enthusiasts dug deeper. However, upon closer examination, the so-called mystery hut was demystified. What was initially thought to be a possible alien artifact or structure turned out to be nothing more than an oddly shaped rock, the Jade Rabbit Rock. While this revelation may feel anticlimactic, it serves as a powerful reminder of the importance of thorough scientific investigation before leaping to fantastical conclusions. You might be wondering if there are any more hidden secrets within our galaxy, especially since even the ones we've discovered face scrutiny. Enter Elon Musk, whose ambition knows no bounds. Through his SpaceX venture, he has set his sights on monumental lunar achievements. Musk's vision is clear and audacious. He envisions NASA returning to the moon by 2025. For many, this mission is more than just a scientific endeavor. It represents a rekindling of humanity's age-old desire to conquer the cosmos. This time, it's driven by the combined force of private enterprise and cutting-edge technology. SpaceX's aspirations extend beyond merely landing on the moon. They encompass establishing a long-term human presence and paving the way for future interplanetary explorations on the lunar surface. As of now, Elon Musk stands as the pioneering figure with the power and determination to construct a habitat for humans on the stunning lunar landscape, armed with detailed knowledge and extraordinary discoveries. What are your views on this? Do let us know in the comments section below, and if you like this video, then do give it a big thumbs up and share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel for more such videos.